Hey, and what is happening, guys? Yankee Gamer 5 here. We're back for some more Let's Play Pokemon Platinum. Alright, so in this part, we're basically going to explore Hearthome City and maybe find some goodies or some... Maybe just say Kung Fu? I don't even know what that baby just said. Could have freaking cursed at me in baby gibberish for all I know. Blah, 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 blah. So basically, in this part, we're going to explore each of the houses in Hearthome to see if we can get some cool stuff. Maybe a little boring, but what the hell? What is this guy doing? My sisters make so much noise, no one even notices me. Okay, I guess I'll have to stand next to you. Just live here. Ah, that's boring, let's get out of here, that guy's creepy. Oh my god, like he's just in the corner by himself, what the hell is he doing, man? And it kind of reminded me, that's why I made the Castlevania reference of, that one part in Castlevania when that person just like, let's live here. I don't know. So basically, this lady's talking about how Hearthome City's just a kid-friendly place, but old people could do stuff too. Come on, it's just like Florida. Alright, so what's up here, this person? I guess she's the runner of this estate. What? There's nothing in- what is the point of this house? There's nothing to do in here. Like, what the hell, man? Like, in every single house in, like, a Pokemon game like this, there's at least something you can get. Like, come on. It's kind of odd that this one house doesn't have anything in it, it has like 10 different NPCs in it, or 10 different people if you don't know what that means. And there's the gym as you can see, but I think we'll be tackling that in the next part as I just want to get this over with in this one. And what do you want? Oh, enough with the contest! Oh man, I thought we got rid of this in like the last part, oh my god. Yeah, I might as well talk about that. I don't really know why they created contests. It's like kind of a stupid feature add-on they made to the game that I'd never liked, like, from the third gen. I guess they did it because in the anime they did it, and, like, to make it, like, have sense or whatever, but I don't know, maybe they did it for, like, to increase the girl demographic. Oh, a shell bell, nice. That's actually a pretty good held item. But I guess they created contests to, like, get the girl demographic up. I have no idea, but contests are really not important, and by what I know, no one really likes contests as well, so... it's a nice feature, I guess, if you're really into that kind of thing, but me, not so much. And as you can notice, Gligar is actually still unnamed. It's been like three parts I've been unnamed. To be honest, I just really forgotten to name him, but after this part, I'm going to go back to the name Raider, because that's the only thing that's like, now I have to backtrack to that thing, so ugh, that's going to be fun. But whatever has to be done, so I'll end up backtracking to the name Raider, and we'll get a name for it. I'll review all the nicknames that were submitted, or maybe put my own creative twist on it. Who knows? Yeah, so basically I gave Bubba the Shell Bell, and I gave Bronzor the Quick Claw, because Bronzor's really slow, and Grotto's like a decent speed that I can give it Shell Bell, and what Shell Bell does is actually increase, it's like leftovers basically, but it's like a poor man's leftovers, because you have to be damaged in order for it to work, so... like I said, a poor man's leftovers. Alright, what other casas can we explore here? What's in here? Oh, is this like that chairman guy? I don't want to talk to you, you're an interviewer. I think this is like that, chairman thing, like the guy from the bicycle club. I have no idea. Eh, you're the chairman. Blah, 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 what do you wish to treat your Pokemon? What do I say, what do you do? He's gonna talk about the Poffins. I'm not even gonna bother reading this text, honestly. It's like, basically, it's like, if you give your Pokemon Poffins, they'll love you. But if you train them, they'll hate you. So yeah, he'll give us the Poffin case, and another add-on to this game, instead of Pokeblocks, it's Poffins. I don't know, I don't really like half the things they put into Platinum and stuff as the generations progress, but I'm more of like an old-school Pokemon fan, so with these add-ons, that really doesn't take like my interest or whatever, it's more toward like the younger gamer that doesn't know like the older Pokemon games. Alright, so let's just actually go into the Pokemart and buy and sell some stuff. Yeah, let's barter. I wish it was like Fallout again, I'm making that Fallout reference, I wish it was like that when you can actually like trade for money, that'd be awesome, but they give you an overabundance of money in this game, so it's not even worth it, so whatever. Okay, I like to have 10 Pokeballs, I have enough Super Potions, I sold some crap. Alright, did what I wanted to do in there. Alright, what's this house? Oh, the Poffin House, that's great, I'm not going in there, what the hell? Hell, this place. Mind and matter. It's no good if one is stronger than the other. Balance is what's needed. That's the key. And there do I see my father, my son, my life. And there I see nature, Pokemon, the world.
The art of crafting things fatigues one's spirit. When the spirit is healed, the desire to make something returns. It is such a wondrous cycle. If the strong and able do too much, they limit the contributions of others. The strong must show restraint. This enables everyone to live together and share responsibility.
Pokemon, people, it's only natural that we are all so different. Make sure that you never judge a Pokemon if it's weak or strong. You must always look for the good inside of them. That's what counts. There are still words that not everyone can describe. The words are love and joy. That people are lonely is only natural. It gives me compassion for others. It's what makes me look forward to a better tomorrow. But there are still moments of fondness for the past, though time can heal some sadness. We cannot read the minds of others, which causes us to feel fear and doubt. But to control the aspects of the world beyond our senses is an impossibility. When people and Pokemon join hands, everyone's happy. It makes everyone come together. It could be even make the world one. Alright, what the hell just happened there? Like, what, is there a church in the Pokemon world? Like, what the hell, man? That was just the most bizarre thing I've ever seen in a Pokemon game right there. Like, what were they thinking? A freaking church in a Pokemon game? Like, come on! Like, that just breaks the... that just breaks the ground rules, like, out of everything. Like, I'm really surprised they would actually do that. And after that weird experience, what better way to cap it off than to have a battle with a clown? I'm not making this stuff up. And he'll have a Mime Jr. Wow, he had one of those cool Pokeballs. Had, like, confetti and stuff. But really, wow. A church in a Pokemon game? Like, what were they thinking? Aw, man. That was, like, really bizarre. And what the people even said was even more bizarre. Like, what the hell, man? Like, I'm really shocked that they would actually do that in a Pokemon game. That's just so bizarre. And, well, so out of place. I don't know. Like, that was really not necessary at all. Aw, man. Yeah, we trumped that clown quite fastly, like, quite fastly. Quickly. Durr. Herp-a-derp. Oh, alright, we might as well heal our Pokemon while we're here. Yeah, so basically what they add in this game, you can fight Pokemon trainers inside of Pokemon centers. I don't know, that's pretty cool, I don't know. But it's not really obvious who's a Pokemon trainer, so you have to end up talking to everybody, so it's kind of an inconvenience, to say the least. Alright, what other houses can we explore? Oh, who's this? Hiya, oh, you're a trainer. That means you're using Pokemon boxes. I love meeting end users. Oh, what's up? Why that astonished look? Oh, right, sorry, there I go running my mouth again. My name's Bebe. Like, Bebe's kids. You know the PC Pokemon box? I'm the system administrator. I know this is out of the blue, but do you want a Pokemon named Eevee? Hells yeah, here you go. Wait, you can't do that, you can't take any more Pokemon with you. Right about now. Blah, blah, blah. Alright, so we gotta end up depositing a Pokemon so we can make room for our fifth Pokemon, Eevee! Yes, if you didn't guess it from the last little hint I gave in the last video, the fifth Pokemon will be Eevee, and I will be evolving it, obviously, into something besides an Eevee, because Eevee by itself is utterly useless, and defeats the purpose of the whole Eevee thing. Now, I'm guessing you could probably guess which one I'm gonna evolve it into, but it's kind of a hard guess because I think there's... Actually, counting the new ones in this game, there's like 7 different kinds of Eevees. It's ridiculous now. It used to be just 3. Alright, my good friend in Hold the Johto, I give you this Eevee I've raised over the years. Sorry, that doesn't mean anything to you. Please be good to it. Alright, so we accepted the Eevee. Yeah, they always give us Togepis and Eevees. That's kind of a weird connection. I don't know. And we'll give it a nickname at a later date, maybe in another episode or two. Because you don't want a nickname before you don't know what the Pokemon is. Like, you can't name it Eevee. Ooh, Adamant Nature, that's awesome! Wow, I got that in the first crack? Holy jeebus, you don't know how freaking lucky that is. Okay, I guess I won't have to breed it. Awesome. Yeah, because if it was a bad nature, I would've had to freaking, like, reset the game, but that would've probably been the bad idea because I haven't saved in a while, so yeah. But yeah, basically we'll be evolving that Eevee into something else, so right now we have 5 Pokemon with us, and our final one will, what is our final Pokemon? I don't know it off the top of my head, but I think it is something cool. Yeah, real generic statement right there, but yeah, this is a pretty short part, but this is what I want to do in this part, pretty much explore Hearthome and get that out of the way. So what I'll give it XP share. What I believe we'll do in the next part is take on the gym underlings and the gym leader Fantina. So, thank you guys for watching. Next time we'll be doing that, and I will see you guys then.